Good afternoon. Welcome with me to Eleanor Tomlinson, star of Pole Dark. We're delighted to have her here at Build Series London. Before we get going, can I invite anybody who wants to send any questions through to Eleanor to tweet us on at Build Series London, that's BLD Series LDN, or on the Facebook page where this video is. So without further ado, I'm delighted to have you. Pole Dark starts again on Sunday, very excited. Should we watch a little clip first? Because I know there's a lot going on for her in the first episode. Yes. I mean, viewers always want to know how she's getting on with Ross, aka Aidan Turner. But first of all, the clip shows something a little bit more traumatic going on for Demelza, which means a return to her family home. So let's just watch her first.
The hour is upon me, daughter. Right, easier, girl. If I know you've returned to the light, the Lord is merciful, and he shall guide you home.
I thank the Lord kindly, but I believe I know my own way.
Samuel. Drake. Tis for thee to lead the fallen souls of Cornwall.
Aye, Father. We'll make it our mission.
Right, so where do we start? So tell us first of all about this scene and how it fits into the new series. What's going on here?
Okay, so this is episode one of the first episode of series three. That's right. Okay, and you can see that my father is dying, and obviously Demelza has a very complicated relationship with her father, but we also see her brothers, who we've never met before. So that scene is about them coming together, and Demelza realising that her brothers need her support now more than ever.
Right, I see. And we're going to see more of those brothers. They're, once your father in the show passes away, then the brothers come over to see Demelza and sort of take root in the series. Do you think that this is going to cause ripples, as they say?
I hope so, absolutely. They've got some brilliant storylines. There's new characters in Elizabeth's family as well. So it's nice seeing the two households mix again.
At risk of spoiling it, so do look away now if you don't want to know, but Demelza, you have hinted that it's perhaps her turn to have her eye turned by somebody beyond her marriage. Is that right? What can you tell us without ruining too much?
I think no one would blame Demelza for that after what happened in series two, but I think she is a fiercely loyal wife and a very supportive wife. But when that support is ignored constantly by her husband, it is hard to remain as steadfast as she always does. So yes, there's plenty of eye candy that that catches her attention. But that was a lot of fun.
I'm glad. Yeah, as you say, it definitely is her turn. Do you think that Demelza, I mean, that we series two finale, we saw them kind of, they were back together, but there was obviously a little bit of unrest. Do you think she has properly forgiven him for the indiscretion?
Forgiven, that's an interesting word. I think what is amazing about Demelza is that she decides to put it behind her. She loves him, and she realises that he does love her, and they have children together. And she has to either accept it and move on and work towards a more positive relationship, or she could leave him, which would break both of their hearts and destroy their family. So she decides to stay with him because love is at the heart of it.
You sound as though you're very fond and attached to her. Is that right?
Very much so. She's an amazing woman, and she's very strong. And I'm very proud and honoured to have been given the opportunity to portray her.
Fantastic. Let's take you back now to that moment when you did get that role. What did you have to do? I mean, did you have to jump through a million hoops? Because you were relatively unknown compared with how sort of your face is so familiar now on Sunday evenings. You know, we've become prime time. But what happened? Were you surprised to get the role? And what went on?
Initially, I was asked to audition for the role of Elizabeth. But Having done quite a bit of period drama, I wanted something that was really going to push me as an actress. And when I read the scripts, this role, Demelza, just stood out. And I was like, wow, I'd love to be given the opportunity to even audition for it. And the casting director was just fabulous, Susie Paris. And she let me, she gave me opportunity. So I dressed in my brother's clothes. You probably already heard the story, but dressed in my brother's clothes and didn't brush my hair, didn't wear any makeup, turned up in character and stayed in character for the whole meeting. And then weeks later, I got a call to screen test with Aidan. And here we are now.
As you say, we are here. You are the lead actress in, no pressure, but the nation's biggest drama. Does that weigh heavily on your shoulders? Do you feel vulnerable, empowered? How does that make you feel when that's presented to you?
Just really honoured, to be honest. You never know how a job is going to be received, but this is, people have really taken it to their heart, and that's so lovely, and I feel just really, really blessed to have been given the opportunity to push myself as an actress and take on this fantastic role, but just incredibly lucky as well, to be honest.
Fantastic. Tell us about what your thoughts were on that controversy that came around series two. That scene, I'm sure we all know what I'm referring to, a certain indiscretion of the non-consensual, consensual scene between him and Elizabeth. I mean, you were on the other part of this love triangle. What were your thoughts on it? Did you expect it to stir up such controversy?
Yes, of course. I think Aidan and Heather worked very hard and very closely with the directors, with Debbie Horsfield, also with Andrew Graham, who is Winston's son. And together they created a scene that I think is something that comes out of the passion of their relationship. I think that it's, I don't think they wanted it to be a rape scene, but obviously that can't be ignored. And there is this aspect to Ross Poldark that he does what he wants, regardless of anyone else. So I think it was always going to be tricky to get around, but I think that the actors and the production team on Poldark handled it to the best of their ability, I think.
Yep, I agree with you. Aidan Turner is mentioned in these days the same sentences often as a certain, should he, the next James Bond, potentially. Having worked so closely with him, what are your thoughts on that? Would he be a suitable fit for 007?
Yeah, why not? But I don't know, but what about a female Bond?
Oh, there we go.
Maybe nice.
Yeah, absolutely. Working alongside him, I mean, everybody loves themselves a bit of Aidan Turner. You know, he's become one of the nation's heartthrobs. What's he actually like? What can you tell us about working alongside him?
He's a gentleman. He's a sweetheart. And we're the greatest of friends. And it's a real honour to play his wife. So, yeah.
There you go. Thank you. How do you spend your time when you're in Cornwall? How many months of the year do you film down there?
We film mainly just a month in Cornwall. We do all the exterior stuff there. But we film all of the interior stuff in studios in Bristol. So when I'm in Cornwall, I spend as much time as I can exploring and, you know, going out and speaking to the fans as well. There's so many amazing Cornish fans out there that are so supportive. So trying to spend as much time in and around Cornwall as possible. And then in Bristol, it's long hours, you know, it's really hard. So knuckling down and trying to get across, you know, 8, 9, 10 episodes is quite tricky.
Why do you think a period drama, all tricorns and I mean, Demelza's way of speaking is beautifully old-fashioned, lovely, quaint English old language. Why do you think it's caught such a wave of appeal and interest with so many people, modern-day audience?
I think because you have two characters at the heart of it that people can relate to. They have a marriage that isn't perfect. It has its problems and it has its hurdles to overcome. But I think that a lot of people can relate to those situations. They've really taken them to their heart. And yeah, I don't know. I think probably Garrick is the real star of the show, and that must be why people watch it. You know, it's not Aidan, it's all Garrick.
Fair enough. The change it's made to your life must have been extraordinary. I mean, because you went from being an actress working, but to go to a TV show of this level. What's been the biggest change to your personal life? Has it been positive or negative?
Oh, it's been so positive. Yeah, it's been lovely. Obviously, being recognised more is strange because I don't consider myself to be worth kind of noting on the street. So it's a bit odd, but it's opened up so many doors for me professionally, and that's really exciting. You know, the roles that are available now as an actress is great. I guess the main change has just been being more recognisable on, you know, in my day-to-day life, because I'm quite a quiet, private person, so that's been a bit odd, but still lovely.
Oh, good. You told me that you like to disappear on the train up north, too.
Yeah. I'm always going up north and, yeah, hiding away in the countryside.
Nobody bothers you up there. You're just Eleanor.
Yeah.
It's always been.
Yeah.
There has been talk that perhaps series five could be the last of the Poldark franchise in this version. How would you feel about that length of series in total, five series? Would that feel appropriate?
I think if we go to five series, I think that's a dream. You know, how many series have done that? It's great. I think we'd be very lucky and very honoured to get that far. Who knows? Who knows if we will?
Space.
Yeah.
You have fitted in some other work, though. I believe we're not going to try and play another clip, but you are in a new period drama film, Loving Vincent, am I right? So what can you tell us about that? What is your role in that?
Loving Vincent is the first film ever to be hand-painted from start to finish. Ooh. So you film it like you would film a normal film, but with green screen. And then they, as far as I can work it out, they take each frame and then they paint it, and then they scratch out your eyebrows, your eyes and your mouth and replay it a frame later and then paint it in again to change your expression. And it's all in the style of Vincent van Gogh, because it's about Van Gogh, and it's a story of different people's accounts of his life and what he was like as a person. So it's fascinating. It's a brilliant film. It really pushes the boundaries of cinema. I'm very excited about it. Aidan is in it as well, because we only ever work together. I think it's great. I'm really, really excited to see what people think about it.
Yeah, very different. Who would you say, this is the sort of milk bottle question, who is the actor or actress that whose career you would like to emulate? Who do you look up to as having it got it just right?
Probably Kate Winslet or Emma Thompson.
I think they're Brits.
Fabulous. Yeah, of course. I think they're brilliant actresses and so intelligent, and the roles that they choose are always exceptional. So if I was half as lucky as them, that would be great.
Okay. Let's take some audience questions, if you're ready. I'm not sure where the first audience question is. Oh, there we go. Sir.
Hello, Eleanor. How are you? My question is, 1975 for Poldark was originally filmed. Have you ever had the chance to watch any of it?
Of the original adaptation? Yes, I've seen bits of it. I deliberately didn't want to watch the whole thing because I didn't want to just recreate Anne Harrod Reese's performance. As brilliant as she was, as her Demelza, I wanted to completely make the part my own and not be too heavily influenced. But I think also just the style of filming, it was so different then. They would rehearse it like a play and then shoot for 3 days at the end of the week or something. So it's very, very different kind of filmmaking, as it were. I don't know that the two can be compared anymore. And when we first, you know, when it was first said that they were going to do another series of Poldark, people were immediately ready to hate it and say, oh, you know, she's not going to be Anne Harrod. But I hope I've just been able to do something really different. So, yeah.
Good stuff. Do we have another question? Oh, yes.
Hello, Eleanor. We have a question from Twitter for you. They have asked, there are rumours you're releasing your own debut album. Do you see yourself going down a musical route?
Yes, yeah, okay, right, fine. Let's just straighten this out. Anne Dudley, the composer of Poldark, is a fabulous woman. And she has roped me into doing an album of folk songs with Sony. And I'm really excited about it. I want to do something challenging as an actress, but also to kind of push whatever singing talent I have. I'm not sure what it is, but it's exciting for me. It's a new project, and I'm really looking forward to it, but I don't quite know when we're doing it or how it's going to take shape yet.
I have a quick question. I just remembered I did want to ask you, how much fun was clocking Ross Poldark over the head with that? That frying pan.
Oh, yeah, great. It wasn't a frying pan, it was just my hand. But
all women everywhere.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. But of course, Aidan is, you know, fabulously fight trained from his days in The Hobbit. So he gave this beautiful reaction. I was like, yeah, girl power.
Okay, we have another question from the audience.
Hello, Eleanor. My name's John. I'm lucky enough to come from Cornwall, and we love it when you come down to Cornwall Film. I run a fan page called Pulled Art Guide, and we have thousands of fans around the world, and they love the cast, they love the acting, but they also love the locations. We were wondering, what was your favourite filming location in Cornwall?
Well, that's a really tricky one. To be honest, I adore Cornwall. I love exploring everywhere that we film. Charlestown, I think, is incredibly beautiful, but I also love Bodmin Moor because I love how rural it is and the wild horses there that just wander onto set. It's so fabulous. It's like nowhere else. So probably between those two, but I like exploring new areas all the time that we visit. And, you know, we're lucky we get to go to the places where, you know, unless you're from Cornwall, you probably wouldn't know to visit. So it's very lucky. It's great.
Great ambassador for the county. I'm afraid that is all we have time for today. So I just need to remind audiences that probably need no reminding, Pole Dark Series 3 returns on Sunday, BBC One at 9 p.m. So TV's tuned, and please join me in thanking Eleanor for coming here today and talking to us at Build London.
Thanks, guys.